Olive, from now on, there's no need to include Mr. Crane in casting.
Of course. And I brought you tea and coffee. I'll just have whichever one you don't want.
Coffee. It's what I usually drink. It's what I've been drinking, right?
Well, Lola said you don't like a second cup of coffee because it makes you edgy.
I want you to forget everything Lola told you. Olive? What are you doing here?
Well, if you're working, I'm working.
It's okay for you to go home.
Oh, I had to cancel my plans. Phil and I were gonna drive up to the Cloisters, and Stephen, my son, he's at Boston College. I was thinking of coming down with his girlfriend, but not sure that's working out. He's picky. Anyway, so Phil's taking a trip to the dump, and here I am. No worse for wear.
Are they still here?
Yes, they're in Mr. Kinsey's office. I know what they're doing. You don't want to go in there.
What are they doing?
All I'm saying is they obviously don't want to work, so you should just go home. I left your purse in your office, unattended. Someone could have stolen it.
No one's here.
You think I don't know what you've been doing in there? I don't know what to say.
I've got nothing to hide.
Well, you're free to do whatever you want, but you're not thinking about your future.
The thing is, I have a job. I have my own office with my name on the door. And I have a secretary. That's you. And I am not scared of any of this. Oh, my God. You're scared. Don't worry about me.
Your expense report is ready for your review. It's on your desk.
I need you to get the dictaphone set up, and I need a glass of water, and then you can go. That's very pretty.